So in traditional economics, we always assume that firms maximize profit. Now, that's not too bad an assumption at all, because who doesn't want profits? But do all people want to maximize profits? Let me tell a story that one of my economics teachers love to tell. When I take taxis, I love talking to the taxi drivers. They usually have interesting stories to tell. So same for my economics teacher. So he asked the taxi drivers if they earned more on a rainy day. Now think, since more people require taxis on a rainy day, taxi drivers should be earning a lot more, right? But actually, that's not the case, because in fact, most taxi drivers have a mental quota on how much they earn a day. Once they fulfill that quota, they go home. So on a rainy day, they simply go home earlier because they fulfill that quota earlier. So once they fulfill that quota, they go home. Is that irrational? Well, according to traditional economists, yes. But if so many people are irrational, then I'm pretty sure you can find other people who do not purely work to maximize profits. Then there's probably something wrong with traditional economics, isn't it? So, well, there actually is. There are two reasons why people don't maximize profits. Well, the first one is that it is actually quite difficult to maximize profits. Most firms actually do not know their MC curves, their MR curves, demand curves, and so on. They can't find the quantity at which the two curves meet, and then use that quantity to produce. In fact, they mostly do it through trial and error. And most of the time, they don't produce at a point where profit is maximum. And also, find me a firm that uses economic costs in accounting procedures. Their chief financial officer will just tell you that you're crazy. So there are theories like game theory in economics which can help predict behavior, but even that is limited because it depends on whether you can actually accurately chart the actions of your opponents and weigh everything out very, very minutely. I mean, if Microsoft could so accurately predict the actions of Apple, would it still end up like it is today? And the second reason is that profits are simply not maximized because, well, some firms have alternative aims. And this is the one that we're going to explore more in the next few lessons.